Hello friends, this is Vipin Kumar here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel Vipin K Tech Tips. And in today's video, I'm going to discuss the numerical problems from GATE 2017 question paper. And in this, I'll be covering the problem from Flight Mechanics 1 and Flight Mechanics 2. So let's start. So as you can see here, I have collected the questions from GATE 2017. So here you will see question number 6, 10 and 12 are for 1 mark each. Then question number 31, 38, 39, 40, 43, 44 are for 2 mark each. Okay, so we'll be solving these questions one by one. Okay, so let us start with question number 6 first. As you can see here, the question says which one of the following statement is not true. So we have to find out the wrong statement out of these four. So if we read the answers here, if we read the options here, the pitching moment of any airfoil at any angle of attack is always zero at center of pressure. So how to know that whether it is correct statement or incorrect statement? So for that we need to understand what is center of pressure. So center of pressure is basically a point which travels along the chord length of the wing, okay, and it is the point at which all the aerodynamic forces act, okay, and the tendency of center of pressure is that it always moves, it always travels with respect to alpha. So it's not a constant point. As the alpha changes, it moves in this direction. As the alpha decreases, it moves in this direction. Okay, so that is why. But the main point is all the forces act on this all the forces act on center of pressure. So that is why if we talk about the pitching moment of any airfoil at angle of attack is always zero at center of pressure. So at center of pressure, you can say here that pitching moment is always zero. So CM is equal to zero. So this is true. Second statement, the pitching moment of any airfoil at any angle of attack is always zero at the aerodynamic center. So if I know the aerodynamic center definition, so I can easily tell that this statement is not true. Why? Because pitching moment about aerodynamic center is basically constant. It does not vary with alpha. Okay. So, and here it can be a zero value or non-zero also. So, zero is for symmetric airfoil and non-zero for cambered airfoil. Okay. So, this is the concept. So, that is why second answer is not true. So if we look at the question here, we have to find out which statement is not true. So we have got our answer. Answer is B here. Okay. But additionally, let us review option number C and D also. So what option C says? Center of pressure and aerodynamic center. What option C says? Center of pressure and aerodynamic center coincide for a symmetric airfoil. So this statement is completely true. Okay, then option D is pitching moment about aerodynamic center for any airfoil does not vary with angle of attack. So this is the definition of aerodynamic center. So this is also true. So not true option is option B. So that is why this is the answer. Now let us move to question number 10. So if you read the question number 10, it is saying to ensure only the longitudinal static stability and not the condition for equilibrium of a low speed aircraft, the aircraft component must be designed to satisfy which one of the following conditions. Okay, so is question mein humse kya pucha hai ki hame sirf longitudinal static stability ki condition batani hai. Bracket mein hame specify bhi kiya hai ki we need not to worry about the condition of equilibrium. ठीक है, तो इसका मतलब ये है if we look at the question option A, if we look at option A, dCm by dAlpha is less than 0 and Cm alpha is Cm naught is greater than 0. Option A says dCm by dAlpha is less than 0 and Cm naught is greater than 0. That means if I draw the plot of Cm alpha, so it will be something like this, Cm versus alpha. If Cm naught is greater than 0, so obviously we'll start from the positive value of Cm naught, and since dCm by dAlpha is negative, so slope will be something like this. Okay, so this is the statement of option A, where Cm alpha is less than 0 and Cm naught is greater than 0. So here the condition one is the condition of static stability, longitudinal static stability, and condition two is basically the condition for the controllability. Okay, if Cm naught value is greater than 0, so what happens because of that? The Cm alpha curve intersects the alpha axis at this point, and this value of alpha is called alpha trim. Okay, means at this alpha, Cm value will become 0 and airplane will be in trimmed position. Let's say this is some angle. So in this position, it will be alpha trim, and then it will follow the straight path. Okay, so this is the meaning of first statement. So according to the question, first statement is not the correct one here. So let us look at the option number two, dCm by dAlpha is less than 0. Now here in this question, there is no mention of the controllability or Cm naught value. That is why this is the only condition required for longitudinal static stability. So our answer is answer B. Okay, this is the correct answer. Let us review the C and D also. So dCm by dCl is less than 0 and Cm naught is also less than 0. So you can see the plot will be something like this. This is Cm, this is Cl. So since Cm naught itself is starting from 0, so it will start from here and the slope is negative, so will be like this. Okay, so if I extend this line in this direction, so you can see the value of Cl is negative. Okay, and at Cl negative value, it is very difficult to control the aircraft. Okay, so that is why this condition does not fulfill the controllability condition. But this is statically stable. Okay, statically stable means airplane will come back to its initial path once it is disturbed, but controllability problem will be there. That is why we can say that option C is also incorrect for this particular question. Then option D, dCm by dCl. So dCm by dCl is equal to 0. That means this slope here is 0. Okay, it's a flat line or the straight line here. So dCm by dCl is equal to 0. And we also know that the dCm by dCl is what? Minus of static margin. And static margin, when static margin is 0, that means there is a neutral stability. Okay, neutral stability, and the CG location is equal to neutral point location. Okay, and what happens in neutral stability? If an airplane is moving away from its initial flight path, then it will remain in its new flight path without any stability condition. Means it will not come back to its initial position, but still in new position it will be in the stability. That is why it is called neutral stability. You change the flight path to any new flight path, that the airplane will remain in that one only. So that is called neutral stability. Okay, now let us move to question number 12 now. let us check the question number 12. Let m n let nm and n naught be respectively for non-dimensional locations of the stick fixed maneuver point and stick fixed maneuver point of a low speed conventional aircraft. These distances are measured with respect to nose of the fuselage, the numerical value of nm and n naught. Means we have to tell what is the difference of maneuver point and neutral point. So if you remember, neutral point is basically the most of location of CG travel in this direction towards the tail, whereas the maneuver point is also the most aft location of CG travel in this direction towards the tail, but in maneuver. Okay, neutral point is basically for the cruise condition or the trimmed position, but this is for maneuvers. Okay, maybe for pull out or for pull down or maybe for coordinated turn. So there will be a new parameter which is called neutral, which is called maneuver point. And maneuver point is always greater than neutral point. Why? Because in maneuvers, what happens? Airplanes, if they are statically stable, they have comparatively more degree of static stability in maneuvers. Okay, so that is why the location of neutral point, location of maneuver point is always behind neutral point. Okay, so the difference of these two will always be positive. Okay, and our answer will be option B. Then let us come to question number 31. Consider a straight wing with rectangular platform of aspect ratio 10. NACA 0012, which is a symmetric airfoil. The span effectiveness factor for this wing is 0.95. It is also known as Oswald span efficiency factor. Assume the flow to be incompressible and governed by thin airfoil theory. Means we have to use thin airfoil theory for this numerical. So the lift coefficient of this wing at an angle of attack 6 degree will be what? Okay, we have to find out CL for the wing at given angle of attack of 6 degree. Okay. So here you can see we have to make use of a thin airfoil theory, and according to thin airfoil theory, as per thin airfoil theory, the lift curve slope, which is for airfoils, is denoted by C small l alpha, and it is given by 2 pi. Okay, it has been derived from CL is equal to 2 pi alpha minus alpha naught, whereas where alpha naught is 0 for symmetric airfoil. So CL is equal to 2 pi alpha, and CL alpha is 2 pi, and it is also denoted by A naught. Okay, so there is a relation between A naught and A, whereas A is what? A is the same parameter for wing. A naught is for airfoils, A is for wings. So CL alpha is nothing but A naught. So what is the relation between these two? A is equal to A naught upon 1 plus A naught upon pi e a r. Okay, so what is the value of A naught? 2 pi upon 1 plus 2 pi upon pi into e kitna? E is 0.95 and ar is 10. Okay, so from here the value of A is calculated as 5.190. okay, but this is CL alpha. Okay, this is CL alpha 5.190. So what will be CL for wing? CL is equal to CL alpha multiplied with alpha. Okay, so 5.190 multiplied with 6 degree. Okay, and in radians it will be 5.190 into 6 into pi upon 180. So the answer for CL is 0.543. So this is the correct answer. Now question number 38. Question number 38, what it says? As you can see on the diagram, there are two values of elevator deflection, minus 10 and 0, and the respective values of CM0, let's say this is CM01, this is CM02, are 0.03 and 0.02, and this is slope. These are two slopes and both are same. CM alpha 1 is equal to CM alpha 2. Because there is no effect on slope because of elevator deflection, the only CM0 values are affected. So that is why what parameter is asked in this problem is CM delta E. CM delta E is what? Elevator control power. Elevator control power, and it is defined as change in pitching moment because of change in elevator deflection. Okay, and if I have finite values here as 0.03 and 0.02, so I'll write this as delta CM upon delta of delta E. And what will be CM? So CM will be CM naught 1 plus CM alpha 1 minus CM naught 2 plus CM alpha 2. Okay, it is divided by change in elevator deflection. So minus 10 minus 0. Okay, so as you can see, CM alpha 1 and CM alpha 2 are same for any elevator deflection, so they will get cancelled. So now I can put the numerical values here. So 0.03 minus 0.02 divided by minus 10. So it will be minus 0.001. Okay, that is in per degree. To convert per degree into per radian, it is multiplied with 0.001 into 180 upon pi. Okay, so that will give me answer in per radian. And this answer is minus 0.057 per radian. Okay, so this is what? This is CM delta E, or the elevator control power, minus 0.057 per radian. Okay, so this is basically the parameter in stick free case, static stability. Now next question is question number 39. So what is there in question number 39? Let us see. A pilot was flying a single engine propeller aircraft and maintaining a steady level flight at a lift coefficient of CL 0.5 and altitude is given as 500 meters. Due to some emergency at the same altitude, the pilot had to fully deploy the landing gear. Okay, so if the pilot wants to maintain a steady level flight at the same CL 0.5 and same altitude, but landing gears are open now, which of the following control actions should the pilot undertake? So let us understand the position of the aircraft after the landing gears are deployed. Let's say this is the aircraft. Okay. Something like this. Okay, so here landing gears are open now. So when landing gears were not opened, so there was a drag vector location near to the CG. Okay, and it was something like this. This was CG location and it was CD or D location. But when landing gears are opened here, when landing gears are deployed, so there is an increased value of drag and the location of drag vector is also shifted downwards. And in this new position, it will be something like this. This is CG location and this is drag. Okay, so because of this drag, there will be a movement about this CG in anti-clockwise direction, which is basically nose down movement. Okay, but here, as per the given condition, pilot wants to maintain the steady level flight at the same CL and same altitude. So what he has to do, he has to correct the pitching movement loss here, which is nose down. So he has to bring it back to nose up. So for that, what he will do, he will move the elevator up. Okay, so elevator up option in A and B. Now second condition is this drag. Okay, so to overcome the drag and to maintain the steady and level flight, what he has to do, he has to increase the velocity, and to increase the velocity, he has to increase the thrust, and thrust will be increased by increasing the throttle. That is why option B is correct here. Okay, this is question number 39. Now next question is question number 40. Conventional low speed aircraft had the following aerodynamic characteristics. CD naught is given 0.020, E is given as 1.0, which is span efficiency factor. Aircraft was flown to maintain a steady level flight and for minimum thrust required at a lift coefficient of CL 0.8. The numerical value of aspect ratio of the wing is, so we have to find out what is the aspect ratio. Okay, what is given here? Minimum thrust required. So what is thrust required? Thrust required is the quantity of thrust which is used to overcome the drag on the body of the airplane. Okay, now TR minimum condition is nothing but drag minimum condition. Okay, minimum drag condition. And what happens in minimum drag condition? In minimum drag condition, CD naught is equal to CDI. And what is CDI? CL square upon pi EAR. Okay, CD naught value is given as 0.020, which is equal to CL square. So 0.8 square is 0.64. Pi E is 1. Aspect ratio is we need to find out. Okay, so from here I'll get aspect ratio, which is equal to 0.64 divided by 0.020 into pi. Okay, and the answer for this is 10.186. so this is my aspect ratio which is required here for a minimum thrust required condition with the given parameters. Okay, so 10.186. Now question number 43. Okay, so what is asked in question number 43? An aircraft is to be designed to ensure that it has enough excess power to achieve steady climb at flight path angle 10 degrees. Okay, whenever there is excess power in the aircraft, it will always change its altitude. Okay, because that excess power will be used to sustain the climbing flight. Okay, and since this aircraft, let's say, is flying on this flight path which is having climbing angle of 10 degrees, okay, so there will be a perpendicular force along to the body of the aircraft or the relative wind of the aircraft in the climbing path. That is lift. It will be drag here. In this direction, it will be thrust. And in this direction, it will be the weight of the aircraft. Okay. And if I draw some imaginary line here, so this angle will be equal to the climbing angle 10 degree. Okay. So if I write equation of motion from this, so what I will do? Thrust will be equal to drag plus W sine theta. Similarly, in vertical plane, W cos theta is equal to lift. Okay, this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. What I need to find out? I need to find out thrust to weight ratio. So as you can see here, it is clearly visible. T is here, W is here. If I divide both the equations, what will I get? So I'll get T by W cos theta, which is equal to D by L plus W sin theta upon L. Okay, and if I replace this L with W cos theta from equation number 2, so I'll get this. Okay, so W cancelled, sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. So T by W is equal to cos theta D by L plus tan theta. Now, here, this theta is nothing but this gamma, okay? So please take care of that. So gamma is what? 10. So cos 10, D by L is what? CL by CD is given. So CL by CD is 10. So obviously L by D is also 10. So D by L will be 1 by 10, okay? So D by L will be 1 by 10, which is equal to 0.1. And 10, so this will give me the thrust to weight ratio, and thrust to weight ratio is basically 0.272. Okay, so we got this very easily. Now the last question of this paper from flight mechanics is question number 44. So let us check what is asked in question number 44. Let me cut again, paste. Okay, so conventional aircraft was analyzed to estimate the contribution of wing towards CM naught, where CM is what? CM naught is what? CM at alpha is equal to 0 of the whole aircraft. The wing was installed with 0 setting angle. Setting angle here means the incidence angle of the along the fuselage reference line. Further, the wing was laid such that XAC location was 0.3, XCG location was 0.4, and whereas XAC and XCG are non-dimensional numbers, non-distances. So CL naught is given. CL naught is what? The value of CL 0 alpha is 0.20. CMAC is given. So we have to find out what is the CM naught for the wing. Okay, wing contribution only. Out of the entire airplane, we have to find out what is the wing contribution for CM naught value. CM naught for wing contribution can be obtained by this equation, CMAC plus CL naught for wing XCG minus XAC. Okay, these are non-dimensional numbers. Sometimes we write them XCG by C bar also, XAC by C bar also. So that you have to remember here. So what is CMAC? Minus 0.02. CL naught for the wing is 0.2. From here, okay, XCG is 0.4, XAC is 0.3. So if you look at this, what you are getting? You are just minus 0.02, and this is 0.2 and this is 0.1, so this will be 0.02 plus. So this plus and minus will get cancelled and answer will be 0. So the answer of question number 44 is 0 here. Okay, so this was the solution of question number 44. So here in this, I have solved all the numericals now. I hope you understood all the numericals. And if you like this video, you can share it with your friends. Thank you very much. Take care.